We're having the greatest time playing the greatest songs and with the greatest, with the greatest. My drum hero, my dear pal, what a ball, what an honor. Hey everybody, we just finished our first sound check on the first gig of the Ringo and his All-Star Band tour for the summer. We're having a blast. Here we go. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Rachel Santos from People Magazine asks, you have so many tour dates coming up. What's your secret to staying ready to rock with such a grueling schedule?
Well, I don't know about the other band. They should talk about this. It's not grueling. Playing has never been grueling. I love to play. I love to play with these guys. You know, we are the best band in this room. And let a couple of them answer it. I love it, and it's not tiring. Touring. Nobody wants to tour, but you've got a tour to play.
I love the tour. I spend my life on the road. I really do. I'm built for speed on this one. You know, I always love touring.
I love touring, but there's no touring like touring with Ringo, man.
Well, that's this true. I'm going to give you that.
Okay. Not so grueling.
Well.
And the hang. We all hang so much, man.
If I'm on the road, I want to play.
Right.
You know, I don't want to sit in a hotel and relax for 3 days. I want to get out there and play. Well, so it's just how I am. I just love to do it. I mean, with this band, it's great because, you know, everybody takes the weight. But, you know, if, like, Paul, or he's like the man. So he has to have time off, you know, to get himself back together. But because we're this crowd, you know, we could play every night. I promise you, we could play every night, but Egan needs a day off.
Yeah. Thank you.
When you play a show, and you have this energy and you put the energy out and the energy comes back and it's like an electrical current. There's no better feeling than that. That's the best.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more with the fact that you get back from the audience. The first time I saw Ringo in the same room, I was 7 years old, and it was 1966, and I was just buzzing and vibrating for a week. And I just said, I want to play in front of people. Recording is fun, but it's nothing like playing live, where you get that feeling back. And there's somebody in this row with a Yellow Submarine sign, and somebody over there, and you just get so much back. That just keeps you mentally just so excited.
I think the audience, you know, I always say it, I love the audience and they love me. Well, the band loves the audience. The audience are part of the reason I go out, because they give so much back. It's exciting that we rehearsed and we're getting ready to go on the road again. We have great confidence we're going to do all the gigs.
Yep.
Would it have been hard for you to imagine in 1989 that you'd still be touring with the All-Star Band concept 30 years later?
I didn't think of it. I was just doing it. And yeah, it's been a long time now. I mean, 34 years with a couple of years break because of the pandemic. And, but it's what I do. I love to play, and I love to play with great musicians, and I love to play great songs, and I get all of that from these guys. When I first started putting all-star bands together, then we would change the band completely. We did that for 20 years. I just did it because I thought that's what I had to do, change the band, but this band's good for me. I'm ready.
What are some of the big differences that you like or dislike between touring in 2023 versus when you started your career with the Beatles or even with Eddie Clayton and the Skiffle Group or Rory Storm and the Hurricanes?
Well, that would take me a long time to answer. I mean, you know, I have a lot to thank Eddie Clayton. He lived next door to me. We worked in the same factory, and we had a friend called Roy who played T-Chess bass, and we were a skiffle group. And Eddie was great because he was one of those guys who could play anything. And I just got this snare drum, but we had no sense of time, and I always remember that. And we'd be playing a track, you know, and people would be trying to dance because they dance. Can you slow it down a bit? She had no sense of anything. Well, you were on stage. Let's get crazy. And, you know, I've loved to play ever since. I mean, and as you said, I've played with a couple of good bands, you know, and I played in the greatest band in my world.
No question.
Three brothers. And it's, You know, I just love playing live, and it's difficult being a drummer and playing live because, you know, if I come on stage tonight, just me and the kit, hey, how you doing? I've got a yellow submarine, bum, bum, bum. You know, nothing else. But I need all these great guys behind me to play with me, and it's a band thing. I love being in a band. Mm. You know, I may have my name, but I'm in this band.
I agree, and this is a YouTube world, and we are a band. If you go to YouTube and you type in Ringo All-Star Band, and you type in the name of any of these songs, you'll hear our version of these songs, and it's a special version. Just yesterday, Ringo and I, we started playing Steve's song Africa a little differently, with two hands on the hi-hat. And Hamish says, I really like that. It's like our version of these songs. And they're great classic songs.
It's great playing with this band, and for the freedom of what he's talking about, that we may change it a little. It's not we never make mistakes. We never do. We just change it a bit. It's not actually what was on the record, and that's fine by me. There's no restrictions. It's like, you know, we do the songs I love to do. You know, of course, we do Little Help, and we do Yellow Submarine. And for the first year, we put in Octopus's Garden. And we change several of my songs every couple of years in the band.
I love the fact that it's not like me playing it with my other band or anything
stiff.
Like that. It's got this own, we have our own sound playing everybody's material.
We put our own imprint into it. And we put our own personality into it. That's what makes it unique and so much fun. We're having so much fun.
Mm-hmm. Now, I like to solo through everything. So
I like to play drums on all of them.
That's right. We have our own sound. Na 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 na. It's our band's version of all these songs.
And right.
The thing is trying to just do your part for everyone else's songs. That's what I love. I love playing everyone else's songs, as Steve said, more than playing my own. Playing everyone else's songs, and then it sounds like this band. It doesn't sound like any other band. Mm-hmm. And then the more you play, it gets more finessed and more nuanced and more fun, to be honest. You know, the more we play, the more we play the songs, the more fun it is.
Yeah, exactly. That's it. I mean, you play the songs and you try and put something of yourself into it, but ultimately you're playing the song, and that's the headspace that you're in. You're trying to serve the song. That's it. Mm-hmm.
And we're all playing with Ringo Starr.
Yeah!
I have a fondness for this song called Overkill that we play in this band that I played with Men at Work. And when I wrote that song, I thought, oh, this might be, this is not too bad. I thought maybe I could make a living, you know, as a songwriter. It's the first time I had that feeling. Yeah. And the song seems to have grown over time, and different people do versions of it. And I just have a lovely feeling about that song, and I love playing it every night. So I really have a great fondness for that song.
Yeah, we love it.
Yeah, we all love it. Let's hear it for Colin. We love it.
We love you, Colin.
Bye, bye, bye.
Free Ride, every time I play that song, I think of Dan Hartman, who was a great talent. And I remember the first time I did it with this band, and I looked back over my shoulder. Ringo playing on Ringo, and I can't believe it. And we will be doing Johnny B. Goode, which is from the album Brother Johnny.
Grammy Award winner.
Yeah,
Grammy winner. You know, I had a dream at 13. I wanted to be a drummer, and that dream is still going on. So my life is easy. But, you know, I did do a masterclass that show kids how to play, really. And just not how to play, just to play a basic pattern to see that if they had the coordination. And I used to do that at home with kids, and then I'd say, you know, if they didn't have that coordination, but I wasn't not gonna be cruel, so I said, I think you should try piano. it's something I do, and that I love to do. I've never not once loved doing it, you know? So I don't even know if that answered your question.
My favorite line from Masterclass is the end, where it's all true for all of us. The more you play, the better life is.
Yeah.
What a great quote that is.
You know, if you're playing your instrument, you're not picking your nose. Life is good.
Life is good.
Yeah.
Anyway, God bless all the writers and TV guys and filmmakers out there. Peace and love. Yeah. Peace and love. All the musicians, lads. Yeah. 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 Woo.